أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يقول الله تعالى في القرآن العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد كرمنا بني آدم وحملناهم في البر والبحر ورزقناهم من الطيبات وفضلناهم على كثير ممن خلقنا تفضيلا صدق الله العظيم All praises are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We glorify Him and we thank Him for His blessings and favors upon us. I testify that there is none to be worshipped but Allah. He is alone and He has no partner. And I testify that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is His servant and final messenger. Ibadallah, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us about our status, Bani Adam, the children of Adam. We, the children of Adam, what is our status? How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at us? Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ And we have indeed given dignity and honor, respect, prestige to the children of Adam. And we have caused them to traverse on land and sea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that we are honorable in His sight. He has given us freedom of movement from one place to the other. He has allowed us to travel by land and by sea. And not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ And we have sustained them, the children of Adam, that with that which is good. We have given them to eat from the good things of this world. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also again tells us about our status, and He says, وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا And we have favored them above many that we have created. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we are not ordinary. We are not just a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created everything. He created the land, the sea, the birds, the animals. He created the trees. He created the heavens and the earth. He created us. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that you have a special place with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And since Allah has given us that dignity and that honor and prestige, we need to maintain it. We need to live lives that are consistent with the rules of Allah and the traditions of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah wants us to be happy, to be healthy, to be comfortable. Allah wants us to live lives in which we are always having that peace of mind, that tranquility. Because if you are a dignified and honorable people in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is not looking for you to live lives of misery, lives in which you are sad, you are uncomfortable, you are unhappy. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, there will be challenges in our lives. There will be difficult spells. We will experience problems. This is life itself. Everything is not always going to be smooth. Everything is not always going to be the way you perceive it. And so we are being reminded that as part of our recipe for happiness and for this comfort, that we should always have patience. One thing, that we should have patience. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us of that in the Quran when He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu isbiru wasabiru warabitu wattaqullah la'allakum tuflihun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the people of faith, the believers, and He says to us, O you who believe, endure. Exert more patience and be on your guard and always be dutiful to your Lord, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you endure, if you develop more patience, if you stay on your guard and you are dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising you success. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you may be successful. Success, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, it is not just because you have some wealth, or because you have food on the table, or because you have a job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the ingredients of success. That you, if you want to be successful, then do these things. And here He mentions that you do not only have that patience, but he mentioned it in such a way, the style in the Quran is that you must develop more patience, that you must acquire more patience. And so our patience at time would be tested. We need to show that we are not the ordinary when it comes to patience, that we can exert ourselves to have more patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us in the Quran, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ, and seek help in patience and in the prayer. Happy life, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, comfortable life that Allah wants for us, it comes through constantly connecting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It comes through constantly remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Indeed, through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is comfort to the heart, there is peace of mind, there is happiness, there is tranquility. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he talks about life and the value of life and what really life is. And he gives a similitude. He says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says that the one who remembers Allah and the one who does not remember Allah is like the living and the dead. See, we may be alive, but life doesn't mean anything. The comfort and the happiness, the peace of mind is not there because there is no connection with the Creator, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is saying that when you stay connected, when you remember Allah, there is life. There are people who have testified to this, that when that they can have all the pains in the world, body aching, different type of ailment, and when they stay connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, they stand at night and they pray, or they do dhikr, or they recite the Quran, or they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly for forgiveness, they are humbling themselves to their Creator, the pains are gone. It's like they have never been affected by any ailment, any disease, or any problem. And so it's indeed true what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, that when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the state of happiness overcomes you, that joy, that comfort, that peace of mind. And when you have no connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're always fretful, you're always unhappy, you're always angry. It's all about this world, and you think about nothing else. There are homes, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, in which there is total misery. Sometimes children don't want to be in those homes. Sometimes family don't want to be there. And again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave that same likeness, and he said, the home in which Allah is being remembered and the home in which Allah is not being remembered is like a home that is alive, it has life in it, and a home that doesn't have any life. And so you find that sometimes that home doesn't mean anything to people, because it's like darkness. It's like it's a home that the comfort and the joy and the happiness is not there, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not being mentioned in it. Allah is not being remembered in it. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also tells us, do not make your homes graveyards. Have that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your homes. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us that there are times, yes, there will be difficult spells, there will be challenges, but never lose that focus. Because if you lose that focus, you lose that happiness, and you lose that comfort, and you lose that joy. And he says in the Quran, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. And give glad tidings to the patient ones when they are being afflicted by calamity, when difficulties come their way, when there are challenges in their lives. Someone is sick, someone has died, they have lost their properties, they have lost their crops, the happiness does not disappear, the comfort, the joy does not disappear, because they know that life is not all about living for this world, but it's also living for the world hereafter. They remind themselves that from Allah we came, and to Allah is our return, that we will certainly return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, let us, if we want this happiness and joy and comfort, let us remember a very basic advice of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was asked by someone, Ya Rasulullah, counsel me, give me advice. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, do not be angry. You know, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, anger, it destroys us. It removes us from that state of comfort to a state of discomfort. It removes that peace of mind, that tranquility from us, where we don't have any peace of mind. And so the man asked again, okay, that's okay, I take your advice, but tell me something. As the Prophet said again, do not be angry. And he repeated it. Because of its importance, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, anger, it helps to corrupt that individual. And it doesn't affect him alone. It affects the people around him. It affects everyone. And so, sometimes you find people don't understand, they don't know why they're having all these ailments and all these sickness. You know, you get ulcer. You have such difficulties in terms of life itself, because the anger has overtaken you, and now you have become a sick person. And it's not sickness, you know, sickness of the mind sometimes that affects the various parts of the body. That is why there is an Arab proverb that says, Al-aqlu salim fil jismi salim. A healthy mind in a healthy body. If you want the body to be healthy, the mind has to be healthy. You have to think healthy. Sometimes we wonder why all these sickness, why these things are happening to us. But if there is filth and uncleanliness in the mind, then it affects the body. So the Arabs, they say, a healthy mind in a healthy body. And if you reverse it also, that you can also say that a healthy body with a healthy mind, if you try to keep your body healthy, it sometimes also helps to keep that mind healthy. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, patience. Do not get angry. Try to control it. And then we are being reminded also about being people who do not live in isolation. People who love to look beyond whatever happened, you look to forgive and to move on with life. If you harbor malice and hatred and you're not willing to forgive people, it affects you mentally and physically. And that is why we are being reminded, Sil man qata'ak wa'ati man haramak wa'arid amman zalamak. Reconcile with whoever cuts you off. Give to whoever deprives you. And turn away from whoever wrongs you. Live by this, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. When you do that, you will have that peace of mind, that comfort. It's not that you're walking the land and you have to dodge this way and dodge that way because you don't want to talk to this one and you don't want to talk to that one. he did you something or she did you something. You know how many people are suffering mentally and physically because of not maintaining the relationship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we must maintain? And as much as you say that it doesn't affect you if you do not speak to your blood brother or your blood sister, or you're not speaking to your mother or to your father, and you think that life is cool and I'm happy, no, you are not happy. And you are not cool. You're not comfortable. It does affect you. That you are from the same mother and the same father, and you do not, and you're distancing yourselves from one another because of some petty thing. So where is the happiness? Where is the comfort? And so it comes back to haunt you. It creates a problem for you. And that is why we are being reminded that try to reconcile. Yes, there will be people who will want to distance themselves from you because they felt that you have wronged them. Find ways and means to reconcile. There are people who may not want to give you anything. There are people who don't want to give you the simple thing as saying salam. Don't deprive them of that. Say salam to them. Let them understand the importance of it. And people who have wronged you, try to forgive them. We are also being reminded, wa'fu amman zalamak, and forgive whoever wrongs you. And you may say, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, that you don't understand what he has done to me or what she has done to me. Who do you take as an example? You take Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the example. Look how much he loved his uncle Hamza. In his uncle's body was mutilated. He felt for his uncle, who thought that he would have forgiven Wahshi and Hind for this grievous sin that they committed in terms of the way that they treated Hamza. May Allah be pleased with him. But in the conquest of Makkah, he said to all of them, antum tulaqa, you are free. He has forgiven them. Look at Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People stoned him, the young people in Taif. And when he was asked, give the command and I will destroy them. And he said, leave them, perhaps or perchance out of them will come those who will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't look at, or don't magnify the wrong, saying, I can't forgive him for this, or I can't forgive her for this. When you think about that, always look back at Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our guide, our model, and see what he went through in life, and still he was forgiving. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, as you think about your comfort and your happiness and your peace of mind. Think about always exerting patience in your lives, always having, always trying to control anger. And don't live lives in isolation just because you don't want to forgive and you don't want to forget. Always be willing to forgive and forget. Always be willing to, even those who have withheld from you, that you are willing to reach out to them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, the dignified creation of Allah, Bani Adam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to stay, to remain dignified, honorable, respectable. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to continue to have happiness and comfort and peace of mind within our lives. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنات من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رضوان الله عليهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, it is said of Allah سبحانه وتعالى إن الله رفيقا يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقَ فِي الْأَمْرِ كُلِّهِمْ. Verily, Allah is kind, He is compassionate, He is loving. And Allah loves compassion and kindness in every matter, in every affair. That's what brings happiness, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. That's what brings comfort, peace of mind. That's the recipe for success. Again, it was said to Aisha, Ya Aisha, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفُحْشَ وَالتَّفَحْوُشَ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love obscenity and immorality. When we demonstrate obscenity, immorality, it takes away. You know, some people, you go to a club and you have a good time for the night. Before you leave there, or just after you have left and you've got back to your home, all that happiness, it has turned to misery. Sometimes you find people who have consumed alcohol, they're throwing up, and they have after effects. Sometimes they can't go to work next day. They have lost pay. It's ripple effect. So sometimes when you think that you are having happiness, it's not happiness for a long time. It's short-lived. It's superficial happiness. We want permanent happiness. We want happiness all the time. And as we prepare ourselves for that happiness and comfort in this life, by doing the right thing, by being compassionate and kind and loving and not demonstrating any type of obscenity and immorality, we are fulfilling that concept of success, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازِ. And the one who is being saved from the fire of hell and he is being admitted into the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the one who has been successful. That's the eternal happiness, the comfort and peace of mind. That's where the total joy, the permanent joy comes. And so don't look for artificial happiness. Look for happiness that is real. And that is found in some of the things that I said earlier. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to experience real happiness and comfort and joy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us lives that are peaceful, lives in which there is comfort and tranquility, peace of mind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Give us good in this life and good in the life hereafter. And may He save us from the torment of hellfire. لقد أمرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن العظيم حيث قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وأرضى الله من خلفائه الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الستة الباقين المبشرين بالجنة وعن سائر الصحابة وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم نور قلوبنا بالنور الإيمان وثبت قلوبنا على الدين الإسلام ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا همّا إلا فرجته ولا هاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا دينا إلا قضيته اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله على نعمه واشكروه على آلائه ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر